They did. She just. I was in a house in the month of May. We're doing home service. Just a pastor. When is your convention in America? I said, in London. I said, well, that's this May. You are trying to find out the date. So you want to find, you want to buy the ticket now. It's going to be very expensive. I don't want her to know the date. She didn't tell me she's coming home. So when I saw her, now I said, no, it's not true. Sadaboma told me that McLaurin said he's going to come. That was about 2 weeks ago. I said, how will she come? She has no bought ticket. So how will she come here? But when I saw her, I said, no, did you put on this light? Let me see the money. Just as they show up as a surprise here today, that is how the Lord will surprise somebody here. This your amen is not born again at all. That amen has a shock. Can I hear the amen? This week, somebody here, God will give you a divine surprise. I say God will give somebody here a divine surprise. In the name of Jesus Christ. Please let me put your hands together for them and they take their seats. You are welcome. Hallelujah. That is Destiny Church, Washington, D.C. Full of surprise. And their pastor is also here with us, Minister Wonder. What a joy to have all of us here today. I'm so delighted that we are here. And while we are standing, as we are standing here, the Lord is showing me somebody who has been healed in this part of your head. I don't know whether you have this recurrent migraine. In this part, in the right side of your head, God is healing you of that. It's a recurrent. It comes, it goes, it comes back, it goes. That recurrent, who is that person? That recurrent, my Joshua, that is the last day. Amen. That thing will look for your postcode. Amen. It is gone forever in Jesus' name. Amen. The Lord said it's a recurrent, it will go, then it comes back. Then it will go, it comes back. And sometimes when you even use medication, before the medication is over, it's gone. Then later, it will look for another way to come back. Because it's an affliction. And God is removing that arrow right now in Jesus' name. Amen. Somebody is here, you also having a condition on the side of your tongue. Inside your tongue, sometimes you have this wound there that you have recurring that comes. And God is healing that condition also. Amen. In Jesus' mighty name. And release God's healing power. Somebody's right leg also is being healed in this part of your right leg. I don't know who that person is. I saw the Lord place a relief. There's somebody's right leg that is coming under a relief. Receive thy healing grace right now in Jesus' name. May affliction planted in your body be uprooted by fire in Jesus' name. As you came into this auditorium, you are not permitted to go by the same. Hallelujah. We also have Pastor Tony here, one of us. Pastor Tony obviously is some in this house. And by the grace of God, is now eyes on ministry right now and launching forth into California. So God is talking about Destiny Church for all nations, raising people and sending them forth like an arrow into nations. As the nations is open over us, so sons in the house are also being planted as light in nations. So I'm delighted with what God is doing in his life and ministry. Greater things are about to break forth. This your amen needs to go to the clinic. Can I hear a big amen? So I want to appreciate all of us that are here. We also have Sanaftalia here. She's with us in this service today. Amen. We celebrate you. Thank you for being here to be a part of this service. And every one of us that are here from far and near, those that came by car craft, I want to appreciate your coming in all the ways you are here. I want to bring us a little welcome word. And God's servant is here, Pastor Jay will take us deeper into ministrations. But I just want to pass a little word across to somebody here in our midst. Because the Lord is said to do great things. This is just to prepare us. I believe, like I said yesterday, there is a covering removing anointing that is being released in this house. There is a covering removing anointing. Show me a covering removing anointing. You are not speaking. I said there's a covering removing anointing that is coming upon you today. Can I hear amen? This is the covering that is start the manifestations of the sons of God. But I want to say, I said to us briefly yesterday, Romans chapter 8:19 said, the whole creature, they are waiting for the manifestations of the sons of God. And the other challenge said, the whole world is waiting for the revelations of the sons of God, for the revealing of the sons of God. And I said to us from 1 Samuel 16, verse 1 to 13, the Lord said to Samuel, go to the house of Jesse. I have provided for myself a king among them. In other words, God was saying to Samuel, among the sons of Jesse, one of them is a king and they are not aware. Not even the one that is the king among them is aware of it. That is, all of them are sons, not all of them are sons. One of them is a king, but is undercover. And that is why I'm sending you with an anointing to go to fill up the horn of oil and go and anoint that boy to remove the cover, the place on him. That boy is not meant to be a shepherd boy, because they did not know what his destiny is. They sent him to the bush because he's undercover. When you are undercover, people will be sending you an errand that is not meant for you. Yeah. Because they don't know who you are. Yeah. David was a king, but they sent him as a shepherd boy. To the bush. They kept him in the bush residential area when it's meant for the government residential area, because it's undercover. Yeah. And that is why God sent Samuel with the horn of oil to go to that house and remove the veil on that boy. That there is a king in that family and they are not aware of it. There is a king on that boy. Even the boy is not aware of it. And that is why I said somebody here, there is a covering removing anointing that is upon this house. I don't care where they are covered of destiny. On this mountain, that cover shall be removed today. Hear me very well. If that covering is not removed, that covering will catch fire. Oh, that somebody is not saying amen here. If that covering is not removed on your life, that covering on your life will catch fire. I'm saying to you here, because there are many of you that have been coded, but today you are about to be decoded. I said there's many of you here, you have been coded by people. And that is why you see that God was saying to Samuel, go to the family of Jesse and take the cover off. Somebody there called David. Amen. And that is why the anointing is here today. To remove cover. Go and bring him out from under the cover. Anointing for me. It's because anointing brings announcement. I want to release an anointing on that boy that will announce this word. Now, if not for Samuel, David would have died on this cover. He may have died as a shepherd boy, never near the throne. And there is a throne around his life. And that is why I'm saying to all of you here, that God did not say to Samuel, go and choose a king for me among the sons of Jesse. He didn't say, go there and choose me a king. He said, I have already provided me a king. He is already a king. You are not going there to anoint him to become a king. He is already a king. By destiny, he is a king. The day David was born, a king was born. But undiscovered. The day he was born, a king was born unknown. In fact, his mother's no longer at home. He's a child of one man's stand. That's why he said, my mother's womb conceived me when I was in iniquity and all manner of stuff, because his mother is not in the house. His mother cannot be in there and do election and the boy will not be there.
If the mother is somewhere, the father is not the one at home. So that is why they send the boy somewhere. Sometimes the rejection people place on you is a product of their ignorance of the real you. They don't know who you are. And that is why I said yesterday that just like Jacob, he was carrying a label contrary to his destiny. There are many of you have been mislabeled. I don't care what label they place on you. I have an anointing from the Lord this morning to remove that label over your life. And that label may catch fire today. Hear me very, very, very well. He said, not about what I've been saying, therefore, is that I am here like somewhere to pull you out of under the cover. You may not look like it, but you are designed for it. Amen. Nothing make you look like what God is planning. I say it again. Nothing makes you look like what God is planning. A man that will command the submission of a whole nation, yet it does not look like it. What are we saying therefore? That is why some people look down at you. They despise you because they don't know who you are.
Yeah.
What are we saying? David never looked like it. Yes. I don't think that guy had a suit. He just had one rod like that walking, and because he's so goaty and sheepy that when you see him, he smell like a goat. He smelled like sheep because he has stayed so long in their midst that when he was coming, they couldn't say that is him. It was the Lord that said to Samuel, that is him. The anointing knows who you are. People may not know who you are. Circumstances may have defined you wrongly. Yes. But God knows who you are. Yes. From the day you are born, he knows what you are meant to be. And that is what this conference is about. And that there are some David in this house. There are some David in the family here. That the Lord is about to remove the cover. David never looked like it, but he didn't change what his destiny is. Even that is why is I have come to anoint a king. So I've come to pull out a king out of this house. What a king? A real king. Yes, he was in the wilderness. It does not look like it because he was under heavy cover. Sometimes God allows you to be under cover for some time so that people will not kill you. If people have an idea of what you will become tomorrow, if this is what they know you will be today, then in the midst of others, you find yourself planted in nations. Many of your classmates, many of people that you grew up with, some people will have, if they have a picture of where you will end, you will not have lived. They will have killed you. That's why sometimes God allowed the cover for some time just to protect you. So that when the time comes, at the right time, you can say the Spirit of the Lord is upon me because anointed me too. Because Jesus, there was something written about Jesus. The Bible says about him that he found the place where it was written of him. People thought he was a carpenter because they saw the shop where he was. They look at the furniture he was displaying. They thought all he came to do is to be a carpenter. They don't know what will save the whole world is inside that man. Yeah. Until when the time appointed for him to step out. And that is why I said some of you here, people don't know who you are. And that is why I keep telling people, don't look down on people. Yeah. Because you don't know the man and the woman locked up behind that shirt. You don't know that person that is just asking for money for transport now. That's a millionaire in his one month's time. Don't look down on people because God can change people's situation at any time. Yeah. And when God wants to bless you, he will not ask your labor.
That's true.
God will not say, excuse me, I want to turn this man to a millionaire. What do you think about him? God will never consult you. And that is why you look at your neighbor right now, you don't know who you are sitting down next to. Very, very soon, you may need to fill a form to see them. You might not know that in the next 3 months, in the next 1 year, things are about to change. You might need to see a protocol to see them. You may need to sign a book to see them. You might have to see a secretary to see them. And they will say, is it not John? Is it not John? When did he become that way? I say, who are you calling John? Who are you calling John? Is that the man? Is that our boss you are calling John? He said, he's my classmate now. Your classmate. Now you may be classmate, but you are not grace mate.
Yes.
What are we saying therefore? Destiny is what you are born with. But not many people are aware of it. And that is why I come here to announce somebody here, the covering on your life is being removed today. And I will say in closing here, some of you are facing some attacks. You are going through very tough times. And you are going through that tough time. That tough time you are going through, you blame it on different things you are going through. Because I lost my job, I had a divorce, I had this problem there. Now let me say this to you, to all of us here. The attack on your life is much more to do with what you might be in the future than who you have been in the past. I come again. The present attack on your life is much more to do with who you might be in the future. Write this down. Than who you have been in the past. The enemy wants to keep you looking at your past so you can miss your future. A.W. Tozer said, everybody can be in our days what the heroes of faith was in their days. He said, but remember, at that time, they never even knew they were heroes of faith. They didn't know at all that they were heroes of faith. What am I saying? I am standing in the presence of so many heroes here, but you don't know it, that you are an hero. Because the enemy keep attacking you so as to minimize your life. The devil wants to distract you with your past so that you will not open up your eyes to see your future. But I have good news for you today, that something powerful is about to happen to your life. Amen. That will put you where you belong in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Hebrews 11:33 says, through faith, through acts of faith, they subdue kingdom. They obtain promises. What are we saying therefore? In this service today, through the acts of faith, I see you topple kingdoms.
Amen.
Kingdom that is sitting on you, sitting on your family. Through acts of faith, of speaking for God's word, I see you toppling kingdoms.
Amen.
That amen is not toppling yet.
Amen.
I say, I see you toppling kingdoms.
Amen.
I see you toppling kingdoms.
Amen.
What God has said about you, you shall become in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Said the earnest expectation of the world. He said this. The creature is waiting for the revelation of the sons of God. They are waiting for revelation. They are waiting for light. If I put off, we put off all the light here, and this place is dark outside, and they put off all the light, and if every, I didn't say you should put it off. No, I didn't say you put it on. I just said if. Please put it on, please. Let that be revelation. Let that be revelation. Let that be revelation. Okay, since you have done that, put it off. Put it off. Now, the world is waiting for the revelation of the sons of God, waiting for the light. The darkness that surrounds your destiny. Unveil that darkness that won't let people know that you are even there. Spotlight.
Yeah.
That is, you are meant to be in the spotlight, but you are in darkness.
Right.
By virtue of this conference, I see lights. I see halogen lamp lights. Push out. They wouldn't know that you are here. If they put off all this light and it is dark outside and no keyboard play, everybody keep quiet. People may come into this hall and peep and go back and don't know that somebody is here.
Yes.
So, but God is saying, he said the whole world is waiting for the revealing, for the lightning on the sons of God. That light is come right now.
Amen.
Darkness has surrounded your destiny. People does not even know you exist in spite of your effort. But I have good news for you. In this place tonight, God is turning on the spotlight on you.
Amen.
If you are down, can I hear a big amen?
Amen.
When God turned the light on, then darkness around your life is shattered.
There is no devil that will claim ignorance of your existence. Amen. Can I hear amen, somebody? Amen. Jesus found the place where it was written of him. He found it. Where it was written of him, he found the place. Everybody had been in that path, but he found the place where it was written of him. You are about to find something written about you before you are born. You are about to find your commission before your conception. Your eyes about to pick on something, a discussion that was going on before you are conceived in your mother's womb. God is about to give you access to intelligence of some discussion that was going on before you are born. God is bringing you to the throne room to hear discussions about you, about this, what we ordained him to be. He will become this on the earth. He will go to some hard time. From that hard time, he will break out to this point, and he will go this. Let me say this to you right now. Somebody already know, if you are watching Premier League and they say Manchester United and Chelsea's playing, and you know this course already. If you know this course is 2-1, and either Chelsea or Man U won, if you know already, you have a free knowledge. Now, you know, if you are watching that match, you are a bit relaxed. If they are about to score, you know, I already know this course. That is how God looks at us. When you are like, they want to score, I say, no, don't worry, they won't score. I'm in control of this. Yeah, they shake you. Yes, you cry. Yes, they shock you. And on the end, you win.
Oh, yes.
On the end, you win. Yes. You are the one that will carry that cross. Yes. They kick you and you are limping. And you are limping. But God knew you are going to win that match.
Oh, yes.
And I'm saying to somebody here, God has already decided you are winning that match.
Yes.
I said you are winning that match.
Yes.
Even though you are limping, you are winning that match.
Yeah.
You remember when Portugal played and Ronaldo in the final in France, Ronaldo was kicked and they had to carry him out of the pitch. People said, don't finish for Portugal. But after they took Ronaldo out, God wanted to show that without Ronaldo, I can still win that match. He leaped. He didn't leap, they carry him out. I know he put his arm in his head. You know why he was here? Don't finish. I am not there, this cup is gone. But God said, it is not gone. I decided.
Oh, yeah.
Somebody here, you have been injured. They have carried you. You are pains. You have put this over with you. I have good news for you. While they are carrying you out, God is saying it's not over yet. You are winning that match. Help me tell the people you are winning that match. Help me tell the people you are winning that match. Help me tell somebody you are winning that match. You are coming on top. Tell me, testimony, you are winning this match. By destiny, you are winning. Tell me, testimony, tell them by destiny, you are winning.
Come on, lift up your hands and begin to bless God.